Here at home, the Philippine Stock Exchange Index kicks off at just above 77.70 after reaching an intraday high of 78.60. So how will investors trade 24 hours ahead of the release of the Philippine first quarter GDP report? Let's head over to Warren de Guzman at the trading floor in Makati. So how are we looking set up for trade, Warren?
Hi, Kathy. Well, you said it. We did quite well yesterday, snapping a two-day slide powered by Property Shares and Alliance Global, as well as Petron, both of which got a vote of confidence from the MSCI semi-annual review. Of course, we did see some losers yesterday, also care of that review. Maxis was deleted from the small caps index, while PLDT got its weight lowered, and both of them fell sharply. We'll see how those stocks behave after the opening bell. Of course, the main key risk of it, of course, as you've been saying, is the first quarter GDP report. Analysts have been mixed about that. Some are saying that 7% is doable. Others are saying anything below 6.8% could have a negative impact for the PSEI. We're looking at a support of 7,600, and we've really been hovering around the 7,800 level for the start of this week. Volume yesterday improved from Monday, but still remained lower compared to last week, when we averaged over 10 billion pesos, close to 11 billion pesos actually on a daily basis, boosted by those block sales. And this week we've been seeing lower volumes because of those IPOs. We have the Eagle Cement IPO, the offer period started yesterday. And of course, on Friday, we will have the IPO offer period of Cebu Landmasters. And we're joined by Mr. Jose Soberano of that company this morning. Joe, good morning.
Good morning.
Joe, good to have you with us.
Yes. It's my pleasure to be here.
All right, Joe. Analysts have been asking us to figure out what separates Cebu Landmasters from the rest of the real estate field. There are so many already listed at the PSE. Please do so.
Well, we're proud to be a homegrown developer in Cebu, and we're basically focused in the Visayas and Mindanao regions. So we're set to embark on an expansion program where we will now be present in all of the key cities in Bismil. So I guess that's where we are apart in that sense, no? That we are homegrown, and we have grown in a span of 12 years, and here we are getting ready to be operating as a public company.
Yeah, and you're based in Cebu, labeled as one of the many growth cities outside Metro Manila. Could you give us some color as to demand as well as landscape in the Visayas? Where is demand coming from? Is it offices, residential, commercial?
It's still basically residential. In the case of Cebu Landmasters, about 80% of our portfolio comes from the residential market. And that demand is basically coming from the OFW market. We can definitely say from our point of view that 60% of our market are served from the OFW market.
And the balance of 40%?
Well, it's basically the local who are end users. And of course, there are also investors, especially going to the higher end of the market.
Joe, the trend for the real estate developers already listed here is really the recurring income. The residential, they say, you know, it's seasonal, so it's tough to rely on that. How are you guys in terms of those recurring incomes, rental incomes? Are you looking into that?
Well, we continue to be very focused on where our strength is, which is the turnaround income. You know? We have been successful there. We're going to be very focused there, but we are also very opportunistic. So as we move along, as we try to build up our recurring income base, we will do so because it's important for us. In terms of asset, we have about 20% of our asset geared towards the recurring income. But that will continue to build up. You know, what's apparent is the pie is growing for us. And as the pie is growing, it takes quite a challenge for the recurring income base to grow as well in percentage, no? But definitely in absolute figures, we're looking at a catch-up rate that will make us very comfortable to have.
And Joe, all the other real estate developers also looking forward to the infrastructure push of President Duterte and his administration. They're saying, they're insisting that this will really unlock the values of real estate all around the country. What do you think is needed, though, in the part of the Visayas area? Again, considering that we haven't seen many of the projects launched yet.
Well, we're happy that our president is from our region, no? In Mindanao, and he's considered one of us in the Visayas. And we have been hearing about the infrastructure push. And Bismin is one area where it will have to be given that kind of impetus. And a lot of these are lined up. We're looking at his Duterte economics put in work. And we're just happy to be in this location where a lot of push will be done by the government.
Joe, an analyst we spoke with yesterday, Renz Cruz of Regina Capital, told us the timing of your IPO may be a bit off, especially against Eagle Cement, if you can still hear me. The debut is bigger compared with yours, Cebu Landmasters, where a cannibalization of liquidity might occur because they're happening at the same time. What do you make of the timing of your listing?
Well, based on our book building, ultimately, it's really the institutional investors that will determine, no? And at this point of time, we are very much covered. No, we're happy with the price that we're having, and we welcome the developments. And in fact, we are of course leaving room for the retail market. And in the Bismin area, there's been a lot of interest from these investors, and we are happy. Eagle Cement will have its own way of generating their interest. We have our own share, so I guess the both of us present in this particular listing at this time will augur well for the market.
Is there a lot of interest as well in Manila? You made a mention of Visbin, that the retail, yes, the retail investors are interested when you talk about the Visbin region. But what about Manila? Retail investor interest, is it as strong?
It's also, we're relatively the new kid on the block, so to speak. But it's catching up, no? And Manila is getting to know who we are. And we're also glad that there's also that kind of interest. And in fact, the book building are basically from respected institutions who are Manila-based. And that is a good sign for us. And we're happy on the developments and the take-up of our IPO.
Well, we were able to speak with Mr. Ed Francisco, and he said you guys had to be convinced to lower the price a bit to 5 pesos per share. How do you feel, though, about that particular price moving forward, the valuation of your company?
Well, we, as in all IPOs, we just put a placeholder, no? And when the price was settled, it's something that even the analysts have pointed out, and we're happy that it conforms also to how we look at our price and make it very acceptable to us. So, and pretty much what our institutional investors have put up, and we're glad at that price of 5 pesos per share.
Okay, and of course, people would want to know where the money is going. The use of proceeds, please.
Well, it's basically expansion, and it's on those deals that we have already forged with different buyers and JV partners, and the proceeds here will really be intended for that. It's just to formalize whatever balances we have already agreed upon.
All right. Well, thank you so much for the new kid on the block. All the best to you, Joe Soberano of Cebu Landmasters, Inc. Thank you so much for making the time for us, joining us from the Stock Exchange in Makati.